really don't though. I really don't though.
What's going on, everybody?
And now a small message from our sponsor.
Shady. No, I'm being serious. It's very simple and in your face. It's just like, hey, girl, shut the fuck up. I ain't gotta explain shit to you. You see the damn shirt. The shirt ain't damn all over the top, bitch. It say fucking Adachi Apparel and it's fucking simple. Fuck. Ain't shady shit about shit, just shady, bitch. It's just simple. Damn. Anyway.
What's going on, you guys? Welcome back to another episode of The Fat Boy Show. And today, we are back with another Messy Monday.
Hello?
It's The Fat Boy Show!
You know, I want to get right into the mess, so let's get in it. First on the bucket, we got A$AP Rocky versus Sweden. So everyone knows how A$AP Rocky, he was in Sweden, he was in there for a show or whatever, and apparently there was these two guys that kept following him and harassing his crew.
Bro, chill, go somewhere. Go somewhere.
Any gun there?
Go that way.
My iPhone. My headphone.
Go this way. My friend. Go this way. You know? Go this way.
You know?
Go this way.
Listen. We don't want to fight y'all. We're not trying to go to jail.
My headphone. Cool. My headphone. He's fucking my headphone.
You hit him with it.
I want my headphone.
I understand that. You hit him with it.
I want
to go down the street.
You fucked it.
Go down the street.
You fucked it.
Go down the street.
You fucked it, bro.
It's okay, bro.
You fucked it.
Chill. Chill. Chill.
Why you? Man, I want my headphone.
Stop.
Why you stop? He fucked with my headphone.
Here, you following us? Go that way.
Oh, let's go this way. This your area. Go that way.
You
going this way?
I want you fucking me. Let's go.
Bro, I'm gonna go keep going the other way, bro. Go that way, bro.
Go that way.
Look, just for the cameras, we don't want no problems with these boys. They keep following us.
Stop following me, man.
Why you sound like you about to cry?
Nah, he hit him with the headphones. That's it.
Sweet, he hit me with the headphones. He cut me on my head. I could really beat the shit out of him. I don't even know him. He's following us. We don't even know him. So tell him to leave us alone.
Go somewhere. Go that way, bro, before you get hurt. We don't want to hurt y'all. Go that way, bro.
For real, bro.
For real,
thank you, sweet.
Go that way, bro. Go that way, bro.
Can we tell them who you guys are?
These guys touch you
in some way? Yeah, they keep touching us and following us.
This other guy?
Yeah.
He slapped my ass and my girlfriend's ass.
They kept following him. Which, I'm going to say something off. I'm surprised the security guards let them get that close to him without saying something in the beginning. Because that is kind of weird. I thought, because they can easily just walk up and stab him or something. So the security guards didn't do enough for me. Let's just get that. Screwed in our brains. But anyway, so the guys kept messing with A$AP Rocky. He kept trying to press them off. So he got enough. He had enough of it, and he went off and started fighting them like he's supposed to do.
Lalong sakat sa A$AP Rocky. A$AP fucking Rocky. Edar.
In Sweden, they decided to take him to jail, and he got locked up. Apparently, in a treaty that the U.S. has signed with Sweden, you're supposed to be able to have a legal team or someone from the legal part of the United States are able to go over to Sweden to go and help out and with your case within like 2 weeks or something like that. And Sweden didn't allow the U.S. to come in there, and so they messed up with a treaty that they signed, which is a big thing going on right now, and that's really big, and that's really why it's such a big thing. And so since they didn't allow the legal team from the U.S. to come over, A$AP Rocky can face up to 6 years in prison because of this mess, which is a lot of time. So a lot of people went online and just started a petition to get A$AP Rocky out of jail. But not everybody's happy about that. A few years ago, when A$AP Rocky was interviewed about the Black Lives Matter and saying how he's forced to be a part of it, he deliberately said that they're not forcing me to do snap. I'm just going to stay black and die. Why? Because I'm black. So every time something happens, because I'm black, I gotta stand up. What the F am I? Al Sharpton now? I'm A$AP Rocky. I did not sign up to be no political activist. I wanna talk about my mother effing lean. My best friend dying. The girls that come in and come out my life. The jiggy fashion that I wear. My new inspirations and drugs. I don't wanna talk about no effing Ferguson and snap because I don't live over there. I live in the effing Soho in Beverly Hills. I can't relate. I'm in the studio. I'm in these fashion studios. I'm in these B drawers. I'm doing anything outside of that. That's my life. You know, my thoughts on this is, A$AP Rocky, come on now. You're African American. You know what's going on with our culture. You know how we have to deal with our African Americans being shot almost every day, being brought down because we're bringing ourselves down. So I don't understand why you would say anything like this, because as you can clearly see, this is hurting us. This is hurting us as people together. A$AP, I think you should rethink what you're saying, because you're using your political platform to bring us down, and not instead of bringing us up. A$AP, come on now, let's think about this. And he decided to address what he said before the situation happened. He decided to address it and said this:
I don't feel like everybody should try to be like Kendrick or, you know, talk about political things just to try to stand out. I wasn't there when that occurred, and on top of that, I didn't go to any marches. I didn't go to any protests. So for me, I can't speak on that because I'm not helping to change it.
And he also said that black girls and dark girls shouldn't be wearing purple lipstick because it doesn't match them. And this is his response to all that backlash that he kept getting, because you tell me, he got a lot of backlash because of that.
What's going on with you and these dark-skinned women wearing red lipstick and you got misquoted? Clear all that up.
It's like they damn near want to Rick Ross boycott me right now. Like,
oh, it's a damn lipstick? Seriously?
It was some lipstick controversy, man. I got black girl. Yeah, black girls. You know how sensitive they are.
Wow.
They are sisters, man. You know, I ain't hear not one white girl make a complaint yet.
Right. The white girls is cool with it.
I said orange like lipstick wouldn't look right on a white girl. I ain't hear white girls say nothing. That's why black dudes be getting white girls now.
Oh no, he didn't.
Oh really?
Because they off the shits. They not on the dumb shit, man, you know.
White girls got some issues too now. Let's keep it 100.
Every girl got issues. I'm just joking, man.
Joe Budden said he didn't like how people responding with the hate and all to A$AP Rocky because what he did. They said when it's time, the black community need to stick together instead of separating.
If any of my peers, friends, if a stranger were in that, that's so nasty on Twitter. I seen that going around.
Yeah.
I seen it going
around. That's why I asked, because I saw a lot of people on
both
sides.
But that nasty bum-ass homegirl, I seen her put it out.
Who's that?
No need to say, but okay. That one of them podcasts down the Dow. She put it out, and it's just like, you niggas that be preaching this pro-black shit, but get evil in a heartbeat. Woo!
Oh yeah, it's all fake.
Woo! Like, I thought the A$AP Rocky sounded like a fucking idiot when he said this. Mm-hmm. I also think he's in a really horrible jam and predicament. I'm certain some of these feelings aren't existing right now.
And that's fine.
Like, it's only you fucking idiots that just won't allow life to teach us sometimes.
Right.
Like, why we can't just let life happen for people? Why we just always gotta be public judge, jury, and like, no, come on, this is not the time. It's just bad timing. The timing of it is just tasteless, is what I'm saying. So if that's where your focus is, you should look inside of your heart and see why your heart is there right now. Why do you lack compassion because somebody else said some shit? Like, what's up? What's in other people's heart don't dictate what's in mine.
So if you ask me, ASAP, come on now. Let's think better. Let's do better, because we are better than that. You're talking about all this. Now you need our help. Now you need our help, and now you're crying so you can get home. Come on, ASAP, let's get better. Next on the ticket, we got Carmelo Anthony versus Lala Anthony. So, as we all know, Carmelo and Lala has had situations and problems going on with their relationship. Well, pictures of Carmelo Anthony on Lala Anthony's birthday with this French lady named Sarah, something like that, where he was on a yacht and they were all, you know, close, as I would say it. You know, it's not exactly, but they were close. Well, he got a lot of backlash saying that he was cheating and all this good old stuff. So he decided to come with a response and sent it to TMZ Sports and said,
"Listen, I'm addressing this one time and one time only, and I'm really only addressing it for my family. Keep my family out this, man. I'm over here trying to do my business retreat. I'm over here trying to have a good time. I'm on the boat with some friends. Them people are married, man. They don't got nothing to do with anything. Y'all trying to expose, y'all exposing somebody's wife, y'all exposing somebody's kids, all that. Like, come on. Leave that alone, man. That ain't cool. Now I gotta deal with that. I gotta deal with that with my son. I gotta deal with that with my wife. That ain't cool, man. That's not cool at all."
Now, come on, Carmelo. We know y'all had something going on. Even though y'all weren't kissing and touching and feeling, we can see that y'all had something going on. And since all this is stirring up, you know, everybody's going to tag Lala. So at one of Lala's performances, she decided that she wasn't having this. This was a city girl summer, not a hot boy summer.
All my ladies, I really don't though. All right, this next song is going out to all my independent ladies who don't need a but
you guys all know that Carmelo Anthony does have a baby mother, because, you know, during that time that he was cheating, which he still is, on Lala Anthony, a girl came out and she was pregnant and she had a baby. And this is what she had to say about him cheating her child, how he was neglecting the child just because he was trying to repair and work on that situation with Lala. Niggas out here explaining how they laid up on a boat with another man's wife. They can't explain why they can't spend time with their daughter. And let's be real, Carmelo, if you're not spending time with your daughter, there's a big problem, and you should be spending time with your daughter. I think that's a big problem, and that's why all of our African-American men always getting ashamed or bashed because they're not spending time with the kids. That's what's wrong with the Black America now, Black African-American men. Our props to the dads that are spending time, but to the ones that aren't, what's wrong? We need to fix this. We gotta fix this. This guy named Choke the Turkey, Choke Meat, he came out and explained. Y'all might think that Lala is sweet and sound as possibly can be, but he had enough. He exposed Lala and showed how much she cheated and how she was cheating. Apparently she cheated on Suggs. What the fuck? So apparently she's cheated on Suggs Way and with Carmelo Anthony, and that's how they got together. Well, one day when Lala and Carmelo were at Babalu, Shug came in and he was like, "That's my girl." He was like, "What's up, baby?" And Lala, she said, "Oh no, you're not my nigga no more." So Shug was mad and all that good old stuff. I would be mad as well. Which led to Carmelo and Shug getting in the fight, and you know, Carmella got sued because of this situation. Damn, she must have got some good pussy. He also said that she was using Carmella for money and still is using Carmella for money, but that's what took them so long to get married.
This is one chick from the radio, right, that was hanging with Lala Heavy. She had her a nigga that went into the draft. Lala had her nigga that went into the draft. Lala had Carmella Anthony. But they goal was to get pregnant by these niggas, right? Lala was one that got mellow. We all know her in the industry is Sugar J's girl, right? But she's f***ing with the nigga Mello on the low because he's potentially going to go to the NBA. Now Mello knows, probably figured out what happened. So for a long time, he didn't marry Lala. But Lala got that baby out that nigga. She was set. Now, that's that. You know what I'm saying? That story's over, all right? But behind all that, the two girl, one of the girlfriends, like the woman on the radio, she used to hang with Lala Tough. Now Lala's blowing up. She got the nigga. The other one, she's salty. She's salty because the nigga she got ain't go pro. Nigga ain't got no money now. She tight. And now Lala acting like, oh, she too good to hang with this other girl no more. So now Lala in a group. Mello became popular, which brings up Lala's popularity. Now she get to hanging around the Kelly Rowlands, the Kim Kardashians. She getting a TV show based around Mello's career. Not on her f***ing career, based around Mello's career, okay? You know what I'm saying? So, I say all that to say, it hurt me to hear motherfucking Lala say she don't give a f*** about a nigga.
Ladies, they don't give a f- out of n- I really don't though.
I really don't. No, you don't give a f- about the nigga now. You know what I'm saying? And if you didn't give a f- about the nigga because you felt like he cheated or he had a baby with somebody else, why the f- did you stay? Why are you still in a marriage right now? Because you like his lifestyle. It was never about you being in love with this nigga. It was about where you can go in the lifestyle. And that's where you at today. So now you think you the super bad because you got a nose job and you got a fake and you got your body done and all that. Just like the rest of y'all motherfucking chicks that was super whack in the body. And now y'all got the fake bodies and y'all think y'all all this and all that.
Which I pretty much think that she cheated too. Because she, I mean, the way she acting, the way she doing it, you know, it ain't right. But, you know, that's not my situation to comment on because that ain't my guy. Now, if that was my guy, she would have gone get, never mind. Next on the ticket, we got Cardi B, Doja Cat, and Nicki Minaj. Cardi B and Nicki Minaj working together. Well, anyway, versus Jermaine Dupri. Jermaine Dupri, he went on to the people and now they asked him several questions. You know, he did a little interview on them, like, you know, like all these people do interviews. And he started talking about women and how women artists aren't right. And you know, how they only talk about one thing when in actuality, men and women, they only talk about one thing, because sex does sell.
Other female rappers, do you have a favorite right now in the rap game?
Cardi B, Nicki, females? Megan Thee Stallion. Stand out to you?
I can't really say.
Not a Cardi B fan?
You know the reason why I can't say is because I feel like they all rapping about the same thing, and I don't feel like that. I don't think they're showing us who's the best rapper. I think they're trying to show, for me, it's like strippers rapping, and I don't as far as rap goes, I'm not getting who is the best rapper. I'm getting like, okay, you got a story about you dancing in the club, you got a story about you dancing in the club, you got a story about you dancing in the club, okay, all right, who's getting ready to, who's right, gonna be the rapper?
So different.
Yeah, what is the thing that you want to see if you're not like
just more, I mean, I feel like at some point somebody's gonna have to break out of that mold and just show us, you know, talk about other things, like rap, just rap about other things besides that.
You know my girl Cardi ain't letting that slide. She had to talk about him. She had to talk about what's really hood and what's really good and how everything's really working.
Okay, guys, so I have seen a lot of people, right,
that nowadays female rappers only talk about their pussy and shit. And now that Jermaine Dupri brung it up, now I'ma say something about it, right? First of all, I rap about my pussy because she my best friend, you know what I'm saying? And second of all, it's because it seemed like that's what people want to hear. I ain't even gonna front, because let me tell you something. When I did Be Careful,
I wanna get married like the Curry, Steph and Aisha shit, but we more like Belly, Tommy and Keisha shit. Gave you TLC, you wanna creep and shit. Pulled out my whole heart to a piece of shit. Man, I thought you would've learned your lesson about liking pictures, not returning texts.
People was talking mad shit in the beginning, like, what the fuck is this? This is not what I expected. I expected this, I expected that. So it's like, if that's what people ain't trying to hear, then all right, then I'm gonna start rapping about my pussy again. And second of all, there's a lot of female rappers that be rapping their ass off and don't be talking about their pussy and don't be talking about, you know, getting down and dirty, and y'all don't be supporting them. Y'all don't be supporting them, and they be mad dope. These bloggers don't support them. They don't give them the recognition. So don't blame that shit on us when y'all not the one that's supporting them. Let me tell you about some rappers that are really fucking dope, that be rapping their ass off, and I don't feel like they get the recognition that they deserve. Tierra Whack, Kamaya, Rhapsody. There's this girl called Oroniku. I don't know how to say her name. I don't even know how to say my own real mother name, so don't blame me. But they be rapping their ass off, and I feel like we need to put these girls more in magazines, blogs. Y'all need to start putting these girls on y'all blogs, because I know y'all watching this. Put these girls more on y'all blogs. Radio DJs, y'all need to hear these girls. Y'all need to play their music on the radio. My fans, I want you to hear these girls, because these girls can rap their motherfucking ass off. And we need to support them. And they don't rap about David JJ. They don't rap about sucking dick. And they dope-ass rappers.
And that's that. And now we got my girl Doja Cat, who made that song. Move, bitch.
Yeah, bitch, I'm a cow. Bitch, I'm a cow. I'm not a cat. I don't say meow. Bitch, I'm a cow. Bitch, I'm a cow. Bitch, I'm a cow. Bitch, I'm a cow. I go move.
And she didn't like what he had to say about that. And she had words to say about it, too.
Yo, fucking Jermaine Dupri just said that all girls in the rap game talk about, all they talk about is dancing in the club. And after he said that, Jermaine Dupri said fucking... said it's like a bunch of strippers rapping. Oh my god. Whoa, 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 Papa Jam Jam, let me tell you something. Listen to me. You have to listen to music to know that it exists. This is the ignorance is amazing to me, because it's like, you wouldn't, if you were right, then how do I know so many female rappers that are so qualified and so talented and so clever, who don't just talk about sex like I do, but there are women out there who talk about other things. Sounds sexist. Tierra Whack, Snow the Product, Little Sims, Lady Leisure, Young M.A., Angel Hayes, Rico Nasty, Azalea Banks, LaKaylee 47, Dejlove, Shy Girl, Melly, Dreezy, M.I.A., No Name, Nitty Scott, Rihanna that one f***ing time, you remember that? So, in f***ing conclusion, Jarman, I'm just gonna have to go hashtag Team Jermaine, Queen of Rap 2019. You're the queen of rap. You're the best female rapper out there. So deaf.
Nicki had to come with her little 2 cent words, and she posted on her Instagram story. LOL, not playing, God's burned.
Hey yo,
As the world turns, the blunt burns. Watch them cunts learn. Fashion icon Audrey Hepburn. I move keys, but you hoes get one turn. Yeah, you get one turn and one urn. I straighten all these bitches out with one perm.
Which Nicki talked about her spiritual troubles and things related to her life, and not actually talking about sex and all that stuff. But sex is what sells, and that's what everybody wants to listen to. Thank you so much for watching another episode of the Fat Boy Show. We'll be back with another video tomorrow. Today, a lot. We got videos for y'all. Keep it coming at the Fat Boy Show.
Tell me pretty lies. Look me in the face. Tell me that you love me.